हेलो एवरीवन, इन यस्टरडेज लेक्चर वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन टू बॉडीज दैट इज DTAB एंड ड्रग कंसल्टेटिव कमिटी एंड अल्सो वी हैव डिस्कस समथिंग अबाउट एनालिटिकल बॉडीज. इन दैट वी हैव स्टार्टेड द सेंट्रल ड्रग लेबोरेटरी. ओके, एंड वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज वी वर लुकिंग एट व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ सेंट्रल ड्रग लेबोरेटरी. ओके, इन दैट वी हैव सीन द थ्री फंक्शंस प्राइमरली. That is to analyze or test the sample of drugs or cosmetics as may be scented by these two custom collects or from any authorized officers, right? So, and then the second we have seen the Central Drug Laboratory can carry out the duties with some time given to central government or state government, given by central government or state government in association with a DTAB, means to carry out such other duties as may be interested it to by it by central government or by state government with the prior sanction of central government after consultation with DTAB. okay, these are the two primary functions, correct? These two. Then we have started the basic functions of Central Drug Laboratory with the third function, and in that third function we have divided it in a ABCD. okay, so as we have seen, the sera, vaccines, toxins, antigen, anti sera, and all these bacteriophages. Okay, so all these are the study of these is conducted where the study of all these things were conducted, that we have already seen, Central Research Institute Kasauli, and such functions are exercised by the director of the said institute. Okay, then we have also seen about oral polio vaccine. So what is the only difference? It is also carried out, the analysis of that oral polio vaccine is also carried out in the Central Research Institute Kasauli, but the head of that particular function is a deputy director, not the director but deputy director. So always remember this thing. Okay, so if you have not written yet, you can pause the video and you can write it down. I think it is properly visible to all of you now. Whatever we have seen, you can stop the video and write about the Central Drug Laboratory, its function, after pausing the video. Then you can also write the these things. Now you need not to write everything as they have given. Just write the highlighted portion, means in case of sera, vaccines, toxins, antigen, anti-sera, solution of serum proteins for injection, sterilized ligature and suture and bacteriophage, where it is conducted, that is Central Research Institute Kasauli, and the oral just slight difference for the oral polio vaccine, it is exercised by the deputy director, but the location is same. Then we were writing about second, about the anti-sera vaccines, diagnostic antigens and toxoids for veterinary use. The function of the second is what? For veterinary use, means anti-sera vaccines, diagnostic antigen and toxoid for veterinary use, and where it is means the analysis of these, where it is exercised, the functions of control drug lab, as a control drug laboratory, has carried out at the Indian Veterinary Research Institute. Okay, Indian Veterinary Research Institute, Izatnagar. The location is also very important. So you have write the location also, Izatnagar or Mukteshwar. And such functions are exercised by the director of the said institution. Okay. So first we have seen vaccine sera, for the vaccine sera and all these things for human use, that is carried out where Central Research Institute Kasauli, and now vaccine sera for veterinary use, that is carried out where the Indian Veterinary Research Institute Izatnagar or Mukteshwar. Okay, and the head is the director of the said institution. Then in case of condoms, the function of CDL are carried out at Central Indian Pharmacopoeia Laboratory, Ghaziabad. Now in now remember the location and the laboratory where the condoms are tested. The analytical testing of this is carried out at where Central Indian Pharmacopoeia Laboratory, Ghaziabad. Always you have to remember the location as well as the where the exact where the which laboratory and where it is located. Means in case of sera, anti-sera vaccines for the human use, it is Central Institute Kasauli. For the anti-sera vaccine diagnostic antigen for the veterinary use, it is Indian Veterinary Research Institute, Izatnagar or Mukteshwar. In case of condoms testing, the location is Central Indian Pharmacopoeia Laboratory, Ghaziabad. Okay, then and such functions are exercised by director of said laboratory. Again, here also the director of said laboratory is the head to carry out such functions. Okay, then the fourth one is in case of venereal disease reference laboratory antigens. In case of venereal disease reference laboratory antigens, the function of CDL is carried out at the laboratory of serologist and chemical examiner to Government of India, and such functions are exercised by the serologist and chemical examiner of the said laboratory. Okay, means the research of venereal diseases. Now they have not mentioned the location of this, but we can say that in case of venereal disease reference laboratory antigens, the function of CDL is carried out at the laboratory of serologist and chemical examiner. Okay, so that you have to remember when about the analysis or the the examination is carried out at the laboratory of serologist and chemical examiner to Government of India, and such functions are exercised by serologist and chemical examiner. Now see, the in first four or first three or four cases, the function is carried out by the director. Okay, but here the function is carried out or the exercise by serologist and chemical examiner of the said said laboratory. So those laboratories may be the laboratories which are come under the government. Okay, Government of India. Then the fifth one is in case of IUCD. IUCD is more intrauterine contraceptive devices. This is the after the condoms, the second birth most important birth control is the IUCD. So the IUCD testing is also important, and Phillips ring, IUCD devices and Phillips rings. Phillips ring is nothing but the ring, fallopian tube is the organ. Okay, the function of CDL are carried out at Indian Institute of Technology, Delhi. Now see, why it is not any biological institute and it is IIT Delhi? Because the IUCD are the devices. Okay, so this is easy to remember in this way. Okay, IUCD is the device, that's why IIT New Delhi. The IUCD as well as fallope ring, how fallope tube fallope rings work and how they are actually, I also don't know exactly the working of these. You can see it on the internet or the YouTube video, you will get a clear idea what exactly it works. So you will get it additionally, and also you will remember it perfectly. Okay, but the remember IUCD and fallope rings, Indian Institute of Technology, New Delhi. Okay, so these are the functions of what we are looking. These are the functions of CDL, right? Such functions are exercised by head of the said department. Again, yahan pe bhi jo hai, head of the said department is the हेड मीन्स एक्सरसाइज बाय द हेड ऑफ दिस डिपार्टमेंट. विच डिपार्टमेंट? इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी. मीन्स ऑलवेज रिमेंबर, ऑल्दो इट इज रिटर्न एज द डेप्यूटी और द डायरेक्टर, डेप्यूटी डायरेक्टर और द डायरेक्टर इज एक्सरसाइज दिस, बट कैन वन पर्सन डू सच थिंग्स? नो. सो देर आर प्लेंटी ऑफ पीपल आर डूइंग सच थिंग्स, बट द फाइनल सिग्नेचर इज ऑफ दैट डायरेक्टर और डेप्यूटी डायरेक्टर और द हेड ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सो ही विल बी होल एंड सोल रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर एनी एनी गुड और एनी बैड फॉर द रिजल्ट्स. ओके, सो दिस इज अबाउट द फंक्शंस ऑफ सीडीएल. नाउ वी विल सी द डिस्पैच ऑफ सैम्पल्स फॉर टेस्ट फॉर एनालिसिस. वी विल जस्ट क्विकली आई विल जस्ट क्विकली रीड इट फॉर यू. इफ एनीथिंग आई फाउंड एनीथिंग इंपॉर्टेंट इन दिस, देन ओनली आई विल आस्क यू टू राइट. बट रिमेंबर दिस फोर थ्री फोर पॉइंट्स यू हैव टू राइट. वेरी मीन्स दीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स. यू हैव टू राइट इट इन योर नोटबुक अबाउट दिस थ्री फोर पॉइंट्स, विच इज अबाउट द बेसिक फंक्शंस. मीन्स फ्रॉम हू द सी डी एल कलेक्ट सैम्पल, द फर्स्ट पॉइंट. देन by whose order or by whose advice the central drug laboratory performs the action. Then which kind of actions or which kind of analysis or which kind of analysis are performed in which laboratory and where it is located. So location, the lab name of laboratory, and for what type of analysis is conducting is the very important. And that's why 3A, 3B, 3C, 3D and 3E. You have to write in your notebook by pausing the video as per your convenience. You can, no need to write everything, each and every detail, but the location, name of the institute, and for what purpose, what examination is carried out of what. Means like IUCD and fellow prints are carried out in New Delhi, vaccines and sera for veterinary are carried out in Izzat Nagar, some XYZ institute. Okay, so that's you have to write in a simple and short way. Now dispatch of samples for test or analysis. Samples for the test or analysis are to be sent by the registered post in a sealed packet enclosed with a memorandum in form 1 accompanied with prescribed fee to the director. A copy of memorandum and specimen imprisoned of the seal used to seal the packets are sent separately by registered post. One receipt of the sample. The authorized officer on behalf of the director opens the packet and records the condition of the seal. After test or analysis, the report of analysis is supplied in the form 2 together with full protocols of the test applied. The reports of analysis is signed by the director and the central drug laboratory. No need to write this thing, just understand. Form 1 is for if I am a drug inspector and I found something suspicious in the medical shop that I want to test by the central drug laboratory, so I will send that sample. But for the sending me the sample to the central drug laboratory, I have some guidelines are mentioned by the government. Okay, so these guidelines will be given. These guidelines are given already, so I will follow those guidelines and I will apply the seal, the proper seal which is required by the guideline, and I will send this sample to the CDL. Now what is the function of CDL? The CDL will follow the form 2. Okay, so according to their guidelines, they will do the testing of the sample. Then they will enclose in the envelope the exact procedure, the result of that particular things, and they will also again seal, and the final report is signed by director of that central drug laboratory, whatever it means. If it is a veterinary use, if it is IUD, means the respective central drug laboratory will look upon it. Okay, so this is just to remember, no need to write this down. Okay, then we will move further. There is another point about the drug control laboratories in the states. Now, whatever we have seen are the those four or five laboratories located in the Izzat Nagar, Ghaziabad, or Kasauli. These are the for the entire India. Okay, but some laboratories are also establish in the where in the states also. So every state shall establish drug control laboratories to analyze or test the samples of drug from the licensed manufacturing premises in their respective areas. Okay, sample of drugs taken by the drug inspectors from the manufacturing premises or retail shop is analyzed in these laboratories. Okay, just now I've told about you about if the drug inspector found something suspicious, so he will send it to the laboratories. But see, if we see the crowd which will occur on the central drug laboratories or the some central laboratories, then it must be very hectic to them to provide the result in a timely manner. So what is the solution for this problem in order to avoid the crowding or in order to avoid the rush in central laboratories? The state should have its own analysis facility or the laboratory. So the drug inspector se jo kuch bhi aayega and any means the manufacturing premises se kuch aayega, so that will be analyzed here in the state laboratories. Okay, so these laboratories also undertake the testing or analysis of drug on the behalf of the manufacturers who do not have their own facilities for testing or analysis of samples of drug on the payment of prescribed fees. The second function is, suppose I have a pharmaceutical company, but my QC or QA department, that is quality assurance, quality control department, I am thinking it is not at that good, and it, in order to achieve the standard quality, I must analyze my samples properly. So I will take a help of this state laboratories. So I will pay them for the analysis of my samples, and they will give me the results. So this also another function of drug control laboratories in the state. Okay. Then the another, if a purchaser wants to analyze or test the sample of drugs or cosmetics, he has to make an application in form 14A accompanying with the prescribed fees to director, and the report of test or analysis shall be supplied in form 14B. Likewise, there were two forms for the sending and receiving. So here also the 14A and 14B are the forms for the cosmetics or the drug samples if someone wants to analyze it. Okay, this is about the drug laboratories. But the basic remains same. You need not to write about the drug laboratories in the state or the above point, which is dispatch samples or test. But just remember the functions of central drug laboratory are the most important. Okay, so here we have end one important point, that is central drug laboratory. Okay, now the next point is government analyst. Okay, so we have many times we have seen this term about government analyst, and now we will look what is the government analyst, what is its qualification, what is its function. Okay, so everything we will see in this point. Okay, so government analyst is a person appointed by central government or state government under section 20. Section 20 of which act? Drug and Cosmetic Act 1940 and amendments 1945. A person to be appointed as government analyst should have no financial interest. Which is very obvious. If I have my own pharmaceutical company and I am a government analyst, then I will pass all the things which will be beneficial for my company. So I need not to have any relation to the sample which is I am analyzing. I hope you are getting my point. Okay, so I do that government analyst should have no financial interest in the work he is doing. Okay, basically. So the qualification, what is the qualification for the government analyst, that we will see quickly. ग्रेजुएट इन मेडिसिन और साइंस और फार्मेसी और फार्मास्यूटिकल केमिस्ट्री ऑफ अ रिकोगनाइज यूनिवर्सिटी विथ नॉट लेस देन 5 ईयर्स पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट एक्सपीरियंस. नाउ द वट शुड बी द क्वालिफिकेशन दैट यू हैव टू राइट. ओके ऑल्दो यू कैन राइट इन शॉर्टकट बट स्टिल आई विल आस्क यू टू राइट एवरीथिंग इन डिटेल बिकॉज दिस विल हेल्प यू टू अंडरस्टैंड वट द क्वालिफिकेशन इज रिक्वायर्ड. ओके ग्रेजुएट इन मेडिसिन और साइंस और फार्मेसी और फार्मास्यूटिकल केमिस्ट्री ऑफ अ रिकोगनाइज यूनिवर्सिटी with not less than 5 years postgraduate experience. Okay, means after the master degree, post graduation means master degree. So 5 years postgraduate experience means after graduation he must have taken the 5 years of experience. Now experience in the case of what? In case of analytical development. Okay, in case of as an analyst he must have worked somewhere in the industry or in the government itself. But for the different laboratories, okay. Or the second criteria is the postgraduate degree in medicine or science or pharmacy or pharmaceutical chemistry of a recognized university with not less than 3 years of experience. Now, graduation means your B-Pharm. So after B-Pharm, we will consider for our stream only, okay. So for after B-Pharm, you need 5 years of experience to become a government analyst and after M-Pharm means after master degree you need 3 years of experience to become a government analyst. Now third is associateship diploma of the institution of a chemist with analysis of drugs and pharmaceuticals as one of the subject and with not less than 3 years experience in the testing of drugs in a laboratory under the control of if one is possessing the diploma in the said field like this analysis of drug and pharmaceutical as one of the subject diploma of the what institution of chemist. Yahan se agar kisi ne diploma kiya hai having this subject the highlighted then he must have the 3 years experience then he will be eligible for the government analyst but experience under whom whom he should have the experience that is government analyst one. Ek to government analyst ka experience hona chahiye then or head of the institution of testing laboratory approved by the purpose by the appointing authority means the head of the institution of the testing laboratory approved for the purpose by the appointing authority. Now who are the appointing authorities? We have studied so many appointing authorities like CDL we have seen. So those are the means government authorities in simple word we can say the head of the institution of testing laboratory means suppose if somebody has have the experience of working in Kasauli laboratory that we have seen the Central Drug Laboratory which is where it is in the Kasauli. So someone have the experience of that so that will be considered okay because it is a government laboratory it is authorized laboratory and head of that institute will provide him the experience certificate okay. Now again there are certain conditions. So what are those conditions? Provided that for the purpose of testing or analysis of drugs specified in the schedule C. We will see the what schedule A, B, C, D are later, but for now just remember for the purpose of testing or analysis of drugs specified in schedule C, a person to be appointed as a government analyst should produce evidence of satisfactory training in physiology, bacteriology or serology or pathology or pharmacology or microbiology and should have the said experience. Okay. Now if the person have the experience of these means we will quickly go through means what are the exactly requirements we will understand we will just quickly go through it. Qualification requirements we were looking at first we have seen if he is a graduate then he will require 5 years of experience. If he is postgraduate, then he will require 3 years of experience. If he has a diploma institution of chemist, then he will require again 3 years of experience. Lekin किसका एक्सपीरियंस उनको लगेगा, गवर्नमेंट एनालिस्ट और द हेड ऑफ दैट इंस्टीट्यूशन, इनका इनके यहाँ पे अगर एक्सपीरियंस लिया रहेगा तो दैट विल बी वैलिड. बट नाउ इनके पास डिप्लोमा है, एक्सपीरियंस भी है 3 इयर्स का, लेकिन उनको उनके पास क्या क्या होना चाहिए दैट वी आर लुकिंग नाउ. ओके, सो प्रोवाइडेड दैट फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ टेस्टिंग और एनालिसिस ऑफ ड्रग्स स्पेसिफाइड इन द शेड्यूल सी, अ पर्सन, दिस इज ओनली फॉर द शेड्यूल सी, हाँ, फॉर द शेड्यूल सी ही मस्ट हैव सेटिस्फैक्ट्री ट्रेनिंग इन दिस सब्जेक्ट. फॉर शेड्यूल सी एनालिसिस दैट अ गवर्नमेंट एनालिस्ट मस्ट टू बिकम अ गवर्नमेंट एनालिस्ट एंड टू टेस्ट द ड्रग्स स्पेसिफाइड इन द शेड्यूल सी ही मस्ट हैव द सेटिस्फैक्ट्री ट्रेनिंग इन दिस सब्जेक्ट. ओके, or the should have the said experience. Okay, so you can write it down. Okay, this part. Then the second is for a period of 4 years from the date on which chapter 4 of the act takes effect in the states, person whose qualification and experience, I think this is not that important. Okay, yeah, no need to write, but I will just quickly read it for you. Person whose qualification and experience are considered as adequate and competent, such person may continue to remain in the services even after 4 years. Okay. So the two important points they are covering in this B. 4 years is, I think so, the means the period at which he can remain as a government analyst. But what the condition is, if he is having the adequate such person, means if the person is showing satisfactory things, or he is doing very qualified and doing extraordinary things, then such person can continue to remain in the services even after the 4 years. That these two points are they are covering in this particular paragraph. Okay, the third is, a person to be appointed as a government analyst should not be engaged directly or indirectly in a trade or business connected with the manufacture of drugs. That we have already seen, means we should not, I mean, if I am a government analyst, I should not have any connection to the sample which I am analyzing. So financially, nor the means no connection, not the financially, or not by the business, or directly or indirectly, anything, there should not be any connection. Okay, for the purpose of examination of the veterinary biological product, person to be appointed as a government analyst should be graduate in veterinary science or general science or medicine or pharmacy with not less than 5 years experience in the standardization of biological products, or a person having postgraduate degree in above faculties with not less than 3 years said experience. Means for the veterinary also it is similar to that of ours. Okay, 5 years after graduation, 3 years after postgraduation experience. But experience in what? Biological standardization of biological products. This is the keyword that you have to remember. Okay, then the person already appointed as a government analyst may continue to remain in services if the appointing authority so desires, even though he does not fulfill the said qualification and experience. This is also important point, because everything in the law is important, because slightly changes can cause so much difference. Okay, so that's why they have mentioned each and everything. So now this, what the last point is suggesting us, that the person already appointed as a government analyst may continue to remain in the service if the appointing authority so desires, even though he does not fulfill the said qualification and experience. Means once he has appointed, but due to some changes and these changes are observed, if any amendment is done, but the person already working as a government analyst is not fulfilling that qualification or experience or requirement which is amended later, then that government authority can continue that person, because if he is working extraordinarily. Okay, so he has now that experience, or the means lacking something will not be produce any harm to that person also, and continuing that person for the work will not produce any harm to the organization also or to the government also. So in these exceptional cases, then the person who is not fulfilling the above requirement, but he is working satisfactorily and the government authority feels so, then they can continue that person. Okay, so this is about the qualification of the government analyst. Now the next part is duties of the government analyst. So we will see the duties quickly. Okay, so I will just see quickly what are the next points. So first we will see the duties of government analyst. We only see in this lecture 2 points, central drug laboratory that we have already covered, and the government analyst. Okay, these 2 points we have studied in these two lectures. Okay, so we'll just quickly finish this duties of government analyst. Okay, to analyze or test the samples of drugs and cosmetics sent to him by drug inspector or other persons. Very simple. To furnish the reports of results of the test or analysis in accordance with the procedure, that is also the same. To forward to the government report of research of analytical or analytical work with a view to their publication at the discretion of the government. Now see, the government analyst have to forward the reports in a prescribed manner to the government. Okay, report of research means if it is a new thing, and report of analytical work means suppose if they have found out some purity, if they found out some impurities, impurity profiling, such work could be called as analytical. And if they have found out the metabolites and something else, then it will be called as a research work. Okay, so with a view to their publication at the discretion of the government means that government analyst should give the view on that particular result, means whatever the conclusion that he will made, that will be called as the that will be on the behalf of government. Okay, so government laboratories will government laboratory or the government analyst will give the view upon that particular work. Okay, so these are the duties of government analyst. Okay, so procedure to be followed by government analyst on receipt of samples. So what the steps that government analysts will take, that we will see one by one. Okay, you can write this down also. The duties, this part you have to write in short in your notebook. Okay, duties of government analyst. So not each and everything that we have read today you need to write, just basic things like about the CDL, the different laboratories, their location, that need to be write in your notebook. Then the qualification requirement in short of the government analyst, that need to be write. Then duties of this government analyst are need to be write in your notebook. So as I have suggested you to write the assignment, so I will check these 2-3 points in your assignment, and I will give you marking accordingly. Okay, so then the next part is a procedure to be followed by government analyst on receipt of samples. On receipt of a package containing sample of drug or cosmetic by drug inspector, government analyst compares the seals on the packages with the specimen impression of the seal received separately. फर्स्ट पहली तो स्टेप ये होगी कि जो कुछ भी स्पेसिमेन आया है उसमें पहले ही कुछ छेड़छाड़ की हुई नहीं है, ये गवर्नमेंट एनालिस्ट को श्योर करना पड़ेगा. ही विल मेक श्योर दैट द पैकेज पैकेज द और द पैक और द रिसिप्ट ही हैज रिसीव्ड इज अनहैम्पर्ड और इट इज एज सेंट. ओके, एज सेंट बाय द ड्रग इंस्पेक्टर और समवन एल्स. ओके, then he records the condition of seal on the packets, whether it is intact or whether the seal was broken previously. ये सब चीज़ें होंगी, जो भी कुछ उनको मिलेगा वो record कर देंगे, लिख देंगे उनके यहाँ पे जो भी कुछ होगा उनके पास. After the test or analysis, the supplies reports of analysis in triplicate इन फॉर्म 13 टुगेदर विथ फुल प्रोटोकॉल ऑफ टेस्ट अप्लाइड. जो भी कुछ वो उस सैंपल के साथ करेंगे उसके 3 कॉपीज़ वो सेंड करेंगे एज अ फॉर्म 13. फॉर्म 13 में क्या क्या लिखा है वो हमने नहीं देखा, जस्ट वी हैव टू रिमेंबर फॉर्म 13 इज़ यूज फॉर द आई थिंक विच इज़ गिविंग द गाइडलाइंस फॉर हाउ टू सेंड इट. ओके सो दोज प्रोटोकॉल्स टुगेदर विथ फुल प्रोटोकॉल्स ऑफ टेस्ट अप्लाइड. जो टेस्ट का फुल प्रोटोकॉल होगा वो उसमें लिख देंगे कि क्या क्या किया है, उसकी 3 कॉपीज़ वो एज पर द फॉर्म 13 सबमिट करेंगे. नाउ रिपोर्ट ऑफ गवर्नमेंट एनालिस्ट. द रिपोर्ट ऑफ गवर्नमेंट एनालिस्ट इज़ हेल्ड टू बी कंक्लूसिव ओनली इफ इट इज़ नॉट चैलेंज अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्रोसीजर गिवन विद इन 28 डेज ऑफ रिसिप्ट ऑफ कॉपी ऑफ द रिपोर्ट बाय द पर्सन फ्रॉम होम सैम्पल वॉज टेकन. ओके सो वट 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 दिस लास्ट पैरा इज सजेस्टिंग द रिपोर्ट ऑफ गवर्नमेंट एनालिस्ट इज हेल्ड टू बी कंक्लूसिव ओनली इफ इट इज़ नॉट चैलेंज अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्रोसीजर गिवन विद इन 28 डेज. मीन्स इफ वी आर नॉट सेटिस्फाइड, इफ आई एम द फार्मास्यूटिकल कंपनी एंड आई एम नॉट सेटिस्फाइड विद द रिजल्ट विच इज शोइंग शोन बाय द विच इज गिवन और प्रोड्यूस और गिवन बाय द गवर्नमेंट एनालिस्ट, देन आई कैन चैलेंज दैट डिसीजन विद विद इन द 28 डेज. ओके सो बट बिफोर इफ विद इन द 28 डेज आई हैव नॉट चैलेंज दैट डिसीजन एंड आई एम आई कंसिडर द डिसीजन एज अ वैलिड, देन दोज डिसीजन विल बी सेड एज अ कंक्लूसिव. ओके कंक्लूसिव मीन्स वॉट, दीज आर द फेयर डिसीजन्स एंड दिस विल बी द फाइनल डिसीजन्स. ओके सो दिस इज अबाउट द गवर्नमेंट एनालिस्ट. सो 3 पॉइंट्स वी हैव डिस्कस इन दिस टूडेज लेक्चर. CDL, इट्स फंक्शन, डिफरेंट लेबोरेटरीज एंड देयर लोकेशंस, दिस इज द इम्पॉर्टेंट. देन द गवर्नमेंट एनालिस्ट एंड वॉट वी हैव सीन द क्वालिफिकेशन ऑफ गवर्नमेंट एनालिस्ट, then the functions of government analyst and some administrative work means how to send the samples, how to receive the samples, how to send the result of that analyzed samples back to the individual people, that we have covered in today's lecture. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you so much.